John Fuang once told me that when he was a young monk, he stayed away from construction projects. And that John Lee never criticized him for it. But then came the celebration of 25 centuries of Buddhism at Wadasukara, and they were going to need to do a lot of construction. Not only getting the permanent construction down, but also the temporary stuff. Shelters for all the people who are going to come. One evening, John Lee turned to John Fuang and said, "If you don't help me, I'm going to die." That's when John Fuang realized he was going to have to pick up his hammer. And he said, "Well, there's merit in construction. There's merit in work, if it's done for the right purpose and done with the right attitude." He said, "So who cares if I die with a hammer in my hand?" Of course, he didn't die with a hammer in his hand. But it's that comment on the right attitude that's really important. We're going to have some construction work here. You probably saw the lumber and the truck. And as I said this morning, don't look at the construction as a time just for construction. However you want to help, make it part of your practice. In other words, the breath is always there, and the state of your mind. This means you've got to try to keep things centered in the body with your breath as you're working. When we were building the jetty at what Thomas did, someone actually put up a sign. We had some engineers, and one of them came with this enormous Bhutto sign and red lights. And it would flash back and forth, Bhutto, Bhutto. They put it up while they were doing the cement pouring. They used it only once. Everybody found it distracting. Spend all your time looking at flashing lights outside, even if they're saying Bhutto. It pulls you out of your body, pulls you out of your breath. So whatever work you're doing, make sure that it stays with the body, with the breath. And you find that you have strength. The people who worked on the jetty said that they'd never worked that hard in their lives before. And yet, they didn't feel tired. As long as they were working and staying centered, they had the energy to keep it up, keep it up. Sometimes they'd work all night long. Because in Thailand, of course, the best time to pour cement is not during the day when it's hot. It's at night. People would then rest during the day. But the work was always done at a pace that people could maintain. This is another thing you have to watch out for when you're working on a project like this, is you want to rest every now and then when you find that your practice is getting frazzled. Don't feel bad about taking a day off. Always make sure that the mind comes first. The state of the mind, the state of your concentration. These are things that you want to maintain as much as you can. While you're away from the work, you want to learn how to put it down. Just as soon as you put the hammer down, you put down all your thoughts about the work. Of course, there'll be things you have to think about. And this is when it's useful to remember that rule of thumb. When you've got an hour to meditate and there's some things you need to think through, give yourself 50 minutes of no thought about anything but the breath, anything but your concentration. And then save the last 10 minutes for thinking through whatever needs to be done. If you're meditating alone, have a piece of paper and a pen. But don't pick up the pen until toward the end of the session, because your best thinking comes after the mind has been quiet. This is the whole principle of why we do concentration practice for the sake of discernment. It is possible to think things through and push out some kind of answer when the mind isn't really well concentrated. But it's not going to be as good as it would have been when the mind has been still, when it's been quiet. Centered. has a big open space inside. So that answers that might not have come up otherwise will be able to come up. So the time of work is not a time to put your concentration aside. It's actually a time to really test your concentration, ratchet up your practice, to prove to yourself that, yes, you can keep the mind centered and you can maintain a sense of momentum. Again, remember John Fuang's comment that you don't want your day to be chopped up into little pieces. A time for this, a time for that. Everything is time for practice. Everything is time to be with the breath, because the breath is always there, coming in, going out. All the Ajahns have commented on, people would come to them and say, I don't have time to meditate, I've got work to do, I've got a family to raise, whatever. And you'd say, when you're working and raising a family, do you have time to breathe? Well, of course. Okay, then you have time to be with the breath. That means moving your center of gravity into the breath, into the concentration, and not out in the work that you're doing outside. Then that way the jobs, whether it's construction work or work in the kitchen or work around the orchard, whatever the jobs are, whatever your tasks are, they actually become part of the practice. We tend to think the practice is being what you do when you sit with your eyes closed or you're doing walking meditation, but there's a lot more to it than that. We're developing qualities. That's what the word meditation in Pali means, bhavana. And there are all those bharamis, the perfections. Remember when we were first getting ready to do work on the jetty? And what Dhamma said, there was an old monk staying there, and as soon as he saw the construction work was coming, he said, I've got to get out of here. John Fuang's coming, says, well, you can go if you want. As for me, I don't have enough perfections yet. I've got to work on those. That really hit me, because I must admit I wasn't looking forward to the construction work either. But there is that other element of the practice. It's not just concentration. There's the persistence, dedication, determination, patience, equanimity. These are important things to develop as well. So remember, we're training the mind all around. It's an all-around practice. Where the quality of the mind is what comes first. So always give that your top priority.